So on two levels, young man engages with people. One is the music, I think, and the text. And the other one is mainly the text and the political, not political, philosophical message of it being a work for peace and the futility of war and conflict and hoping for a better future, which never happened. And I was very lucky, in fact, in that Guy Wilson of the Royal Armoury, he's collated the text. It had a Muslim call to prayer. It had a poem by a Japanese poet, Toge Sakichi, who died as a result of the Hiroshima bomb. He developed leukemia. It's a clutch of British poets, English and Irish poets, Tennyson, Swift, Dryden, biblical extracts, Mahabharata, which is a Hindu epic. So it was for all people. And oh, of course, and the commission dictated that it had to have some mass movements, because they wanted to call it Mass for Peace. So we included four mass movements, and to use the little tune L'Homme Armé, which came from the court of Charles the Bold in Burgundy in 15-something, which just said, beware of the armed man.
as we celebrate the 20th anniversary of The Armed Man, we've been joined across the course of this project by several amazing organisations who've been involved in creating its legacy. Amongst them are the World Orchestra for Peace and the World Choir for Peace, whose music forms the basis of the film that we've seen tonight. And with them, we've been joined across the course of this project by the National Youth Choirs of Great Britain, who sang on the first recording and were also involved in the premiere in the year 2000. Now, that premiere was hosted by Classic FM at the Royal Albert Hall, and fittingly, Classic FM are our hosts this evening too.
To find out more about the legacy of this wonderful piece of music, we spoke to some of the people involved in its story.
For me, there's really no better piece than The Armed Man to unite singers and instrumentalists from all over the world to sing and play together for peace.
This personal greeting from the World Orchestra for Peace is what we uniquely do and why we were so happy to be asked by Karl to join in Berlin as his orchestra.
Obviously, it was wonderful to be asked to do it as the National Youth Choir. The recording followed on from the premiere in the Royal Albert Hall. The whole recording was put together in one day. Now there's a lot of music in this piece, so I am really impressed if the choir managed to do that, because they had a lot of rehearsal beforehand, so I'm reckoning that they came being able to sing this thing backwards from memory and upside down.
I was 19 at the time of the performance and 20 for the recording. And if I'm completely honest, I don't think I had any sense of what it would become.
What an amazing opportunity for people of that age to be able not only to sing this iconic piece, but they also got to record it in that amazing venue as well. So such a lovely opportunity for them.
The occasion of the concert was the 100th anniversary of the end of the First World War, and what better piece for this occasion than the Mass for Peace. This is really a multilingual and multi-faith work that speaks for our cultural diversity and reminds us that we all should be one human race, one heart, and that our voices are joining in harmony. For my opinion, we need this Mass for Peace and the people who are singing together more than ever in these difficult times. And I'm very happy that you, Tori, and Jamie are making this possible with the project and your stay-at-home choir. Thank you for this.
It was always important to our founder, Sir George Scholte, with whom I co-founded the orchestra, to show the world, and particularly the politicians, that it is possible for people who don't speak the same language to come together for the cause of peace and to make beautiful music together, to make a powerful statement for peace. We want to encourage as many people as possible to make music together in harmony and in peace, and that's what we are all about.
I'm delighted that so many of our current and former members have got involved in your recording so much down the line from when they did it in 2001 as well, that it might be nice to do a sort of little bonus feature. And so here is the NYCGB Fellowship Octet singing Locus Iste by Sir Karl Jenkins.
Locus Iste, Locus Iste, Locus Iste, Locus Iste. Ad Deo factus est, in estimabile. Sibilis. Cool.